Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today we're talking sheet masks. Yes, my patients who regularly wear sheet masks look younger. They need less products, and that's one of the things I like most about them, is the patients who use these seem to be on less skincare products, and they need less of them because I believe they have a more balanced stratum corneum. That stratum corneum is key, and that's the outer layer of skin that's now very well recognized. That's the barrier that prevents unwanted materials from entering the skin and excess loss of water from exiting the body. Very key if you're going to have glowing, tighter skin. Sheet masks come in many varieties, but no matter which ones you use, you'll benefit from this video today because I'm going to tell you the 10 most common mistakes I see that those using sheet masks make. How do I know about sheet masks? Well, I have my own genuine, authentic K-Beauty mask. Many of you are using, many of you have seen. And if you go to the more info below this video, I put a code in the links, as well as the link directly to the masks, for a special offer for those people who are my YouTube followers here. So at the end of the video, you can go and you can research more about mine and use that code should you want them. Again, it doesn't matter what masks you're using, I've made this video so you will benefit. You see, sheet masks originated in Korea, actually, and when I go there, I see so many different types, but one common theme is so many people are using them. For those who may not know much about them, they're made of a membrane that's fully soaked in beneficial ingredients. And those ingredients can be one of many things, like antioxidants, vitamins. In the case of K-Beauty, they're very soothing, anti-allergenic components, but yet they're very effective, especially if they're used consistently. But I'll take you through these 10 mistakes. So the number one mistake, and this one is in fact in order of number one that I see, is failing to prep your skin properly. You don't want to apply the sheet mask to a dirty face. One of the benefits of a sheet mask is it absorbs amazingly well into skin, and you want that absorption to be perfect. You should apply your sheet mask to a freshly cleansed canvas. Your canvas, of course, being your skin, your bare skin, if you're going to get optimal results. Absorption is a difficulty you see for many skincare products. That's what we always research. How do you get products deeper? But for masks, they have the benefit of being on your skin, for mine, for about 20 minutes as an example, 20 to 30 minutes. So if you prep the skin properly, you'll get amazing, if not magic-like results. A lot of people say, it's like magic, and that's because of the absorption. Here's a great time where you might consider double cleansing if you're wearing makeup, because the double cleanse can cause irritation, but it does remove everything, but then you got a soothing mask afterwards. Number two, not following the instructions. I want to show you something here. If you take a mask like this, so if you open it up, mine come in fives, okay, so you take it out. I spent a great deal of time working on the instructions in the back, okay, because a lot of people think you just take a mask out, you put it on the face. Some of them actually have a membrane that has to come off that keeps the integrity of the mask, especially the higher end ones, where they can't keep the integrity without an actual layer that's on there to keep it moist. So following the instructions, I feel like people just take them out and they put them on. The instructions are key, and it's going to make a little more sense as I tell you the amount of time you need your mask on. What happens if you don't follow the actual time frame that's recommended? That can be bad too. Number three is not having your mask adhere to your face. It sounds kind of simple, but if you're watching this video, you can see her putting the mask on and then she smooths it over her face. If you look closely at this one, you see around the nose, there's air bubbles. Certain places on the face, you're going to see air bubbles. But the nose and the eyes, also the chin, are going to be a couple areas, basically the angles of the face. And you'll see over time, if people miss the same spot, the areas that the mask touched looked younger, and then there's areas that the mask didn't touch. So it is nice to have a mirror, make sure there's no air bubbles, make sure it's exactly on those hard to reach places, especially because it helps the T-zone and the pores, another area where there's an angle, which is at the brows and on the nose. So make sure it touches the whole face. A good mask has a membrane or the mask part that actually will adhere to the face, and it is supple so it can kind of navigate those areas that it might not fit that well, such as the nose and chin. Of a cheaper mask, sometimes you have a stiffer one, and it's just impossible to get it to adhere to the face properly. So there is a difference in that membrane. What are they typically made of? The mask itself, cotton, different fibers, cellulose, or even coconut pulp. Number four is applying moisturizer before your mask. This is a huge no-no, but I hear people more and more trying to do this. You never want to moisturize or use sunscreen before your mask. Sounds obvious to some, but some people particularly will add this moisturizer. Remember, both sunscreen and a moisturizer are occlusives in effect. And again, we want absorption of the mask. It's one of the big benefits. Number five, and this one's so important, but people don't kind of realize that they think more is better, but if you leave the mask on too long, it's a problem. Some people even go to sleep with their masks. Very bad. When you put your mask on, there's a certain amount of time that we study the ingredients to be absorptive. As you leave it on too long, you can actually get something called reverse osmosis. And that's where things start leaving your skin and coming into that mask sheet. And that is something you don't want, reverse osmosis. So there's an optimal time. For mine, it's 20 to 30 minutes is fine. After 30, you're not getting much more benefit, and you might get that reverse osmosis because it's not as damp. Number five is washing your face after applying your sheet mask. It feels dewy, it feels soft, and some people are like, let's get that off. But the benefit of the sheet mask doesn't end when you remove it. It can continue long afterwards. Instead of removing that excess essence from your face, the essence is the liquid that's in the packet, you want to take full advantage by tapping it into your skin and allowing the hydrating essence and the ingredients from that mask to soak in fully. If you wash your face, you're wasting all of that skin nourishing goodness. Once it dries, then you can seal it in. Remember, in mine, for instance, there's hyaluronic acid. So once it dries, your face might feel a little more dry. You want to seal it in with a great moisturizer such as Ultra Moisture that has organic oils in it. Number seven is not using the excess essence, the liquid that comes in it. So if you look at the mask, like I showed you here, when you open it, you take it apart, there's actual liquid in here that's going to be left over. You want to use that. Where? Arms, décolleté, knees, anywhere you're seeing loose skin. In my case, it's a bright and a tight mask. Anywhere you want brighter or tighter skin, you may use that. Number eight is stopping the rest of your skincare routine. This is exactly what you should be pairing your routine with. Like I said, that Ultra Moisture. And if you are using retinols or AHA creams, you want to then apply them after and continue your skincare routine. If people are slugging or they're really moisturizing the skin after at night, that can be a very good option after the mask. So you don't have to add your active like a retinol or an AHA that night. You can use them the following night. Why do I say night? Because masks are so relaxing, most people apply them at night just before bed, half hour to an hour before bed. Ceramides are another good option you can add after the mask. Number nine is sunscreen use. You don't want to apply sunscreen after a mask if you can help it. That's why so many people use them at night. If you need to, of course, if you're going out in the sun, the longer you wait, first seal it in with the Ultra Moisture, and then you want to put your sunscreen on top. That would be the way to do it. But try and avoid sunscreen right after the mask. We want perfect absorption. Number 10, this is very important. People don't use them consistently. If you go to Asia, you go to Korea, I'm going next week. One thing you notice, people are consistent with their skincare. And when you have ingredients such as the ones they use, they're not harsh, often like the Western society's ingredients. So they're very consistent with skincare because they're not getting redness and inflammation. Consistently using great skincare is much more important than hammering the skin with all these actives that people believe are going to make them look 10 years younger in 10 days. So it's consistency, and K-beauty products and K-beauty ingredients are ones you can use over time, but consistently using a mask, how often? I recommend twice a week. Are you using masks? Do you have tips to add? If you like this video, you're gonna love this video and other things you can do at home. Remember to use the code if you wanna try my masks. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.